And there is Jason Rosario. Jason, how are you? ¿Cómo estás?
Bien, bien, gracias a Dios. ¿Y usted?
I'm doing well. He says he's doing fine. First of all, Jason, can you tell us how is your family? How are you doing during this time of the coronavirus? ¿Cómo está ti y todo tu familia y con durante de esta coronavirus?
Estamos bien, gracias a Dios, dentro de lo que cabe. Podemos decir que estamos perfectamente fuera de peligro, en cuanto a que no nos estamos exponiendo fuera de la calle. Estamos en casa, llevando lo que dice la ley, y estamos bien, gracias a Dios.
He said that, I am fine. My family is doing well. We are out of the way of danger. We are maintaining our social distancing. We are in the house. We're not in the streets. So we are doing fine and doing well and healthy. Well, that's great to know, Jason. Jason, can you tell us about, you are the super welterweight champion of the world. Tú eres el campeón del mundo, el 144 libras. ¿Cómo era ese momento cuando agarraste el título mundial contra Julian Williams? How did you feel winning the world title against Julian Williams back on January 18th?
Bueno, realmente fue algo grande, fue algo que trabajé toda mi carrera para esto, y fue muy emocionante. Pudieron ver que las lágrimas salían y no podían parar de salir mis lágrimas.
He said it was very emotional. You all saw that I couldn't hold back the tears, that I was overwhelmed by emotion. It was a very momentous occasion for me, and it was just such a joyous occasion. Jason, heading into that fight, you were going to be fighting Julian Williams in his hometown of Philadelphia. Can you tell us about what you felt heading into that fight? Peleaste contra Julian Williams en el casa de Julian in Philadelphia. ¿Qué era el pensamiento de ti entrando a esa pelea?
Tengo realmente, yo decía ahí dentro de mí, tengo que dejar todo claro, tengo que enseñar verdaderamente quién es Jason Rosario en el boxeo.
He said, heading into that fight, I knew that I had to prove and show the world who Jason Rosario is. And I needed to go ahead and really prove that I am elite. Jason, in that fight against Julian Williams, did you feel like that you needed a stoppage? ¿Pensaste que necesitas agarrar esa pelea vía el knockout porque está peleando a Julian Williams en Filadelfia?
Creo que realmente pensaba que podía ganar de cualquier forma, como decisión, como knockout, pero realmente me preparé para no dejarle nada a los jueces, para no dejarle el trabajo a los jueces.
He stated, look, I felt like I could win the fight if it went to the decision or by knockout. By any means, I felt I could win the fight, but I prepared myself to go out and get the victory and not leave it in the hands of the judges. Were you surprised that he came forward at you? Era una sorpresa para ti que estaba muy agresivo Julian Williams en esa pelea contra ti.
Realmente no, creo que todo lo hizo fue por confianza. Él pensaba que podía ganarme fácil, no fácil, él pensaba que podía ganarme sin problemas. Y realmente creo que no fue una sorpresa para mí. Yo sabía que él venía a pelear, que él venía a dar a hacer algo como sorprendente conmigo. Y realmente no me lo encontré raro que él viniera a hacerme frente.
He stated, it didn't surprise me that he came forward and he was trying to, be aggressive. I know that Julian Williams was very confident heading into that fight against me, but no, it did not surprise me whatsoever that Julian Williams was aggressive and walking forward towards me, but I was prepared for it. How did your life change following that victory when you became the champion of the world? ¿Cómo cambió tu vida cuando agarraste y gané el título mundial contra Julian Williams?
Bueno, creo que mi vida cambió en todos los ámbitos. Mi vida cambió lo que las personas me miran diferente, cambió el estatus de mi familia, prácticamente, socialmente. Creo que cambió en todo. Mi vida cambió en todos los sentidos de la palabra.
In every aspect of life, it totally changed. I mean, from a financial standpoint, everything to do with my family, it totally changed. How does the public receive you down in the Dominican Republic? ¿Cómo sentí y los aficionados del boxeo ahí en tu país de República Dominicana? ¿Cómo está la gente contigo? ¿Están muy emocionante cuando agarraste esta victoria contra Julian Williams ganando el título mundial?
Claro, las personas ya, o sea, los que no confiaban en mí ya se los convencí totalmente. Realmente los fanáticos aquí en Dominicana me tienen gran aprecio y creen mucho en mí, creen que voy a seguir siendo campeón por mucho tiempo. Realmente los dominicanos están con banana.
The fans of the Dominican Republic are squarely with the banana, but for those who were on the fence about me or didn't believe in me, I made them believers. But the fans of the Dominican Republic are very happy and they're very proud of me, and they believe I'm going to be a world champion for quite some time. Let's go back a few years, Jason, when you fought Nate Gallimore. What did you learn from that fight, your first and only loss in your professional career? ¿Qué aprendiste en la pelea? ¿Cuánto agarraste una derrota, tu primera y única derrota contra Nate Gallimore?
Creo que yo aprendí que la humildad está sobre todo. Creo que aprendí también que los peleadores no se noquean con un golpe. Creo que aprendí que para ser mejor hay que trabajar duro. Creo que esa pelea me enseñó lo suficiente para yo llegar al título del mundo.
He said, I knew, going ahead and fighting Nate Gallimore, I learned that I could just, throw big punches to be able to go ahead and finish off an opponent. I needed to really, pay attention to my game plan and use my boxing ability in order to, get the victory, that he wasn't going to just fall right away. Jason, for you, moving forward, who do you want next in the super welterweight division? Jermell Charlo has come out and said that he would like a fight with you, and even if it's with fans or without fans. So what are your thoughts on that? Jermell Charlo está diciendo que quiere una pelea contigo para agarrar todo en la división y los títulos. ¿Qué piensas de eso, que Jermell Charlo está diciendo que quiere una pelea contigo?
Realmente yo estoy disponible para él, yo también lo quiero los títulos de la 154. Creo que él y yo tenemos eso en común, él quiere mis títulos, yo quiero el de él. Creo que mi promotor es mi guía, él está trabajando en los próximos días. En los próximos días me estará dando informaciones de qué va a pasar con mi carrera, de qué va a pasar en el tiempo adelante. Sí quiero pelear con Chelo, yo estoy de acuerdo con él.
He said, I'm
Ahora
from.
está de mi promotor, Samson, yo hago lo que él diga que yo haga.
I will do what my promoter Samson says. I know that he is having a few conversations in regards to my career. He's going to let me know what is going to be happening. He's going to inform me about what the next steps are. But I'm familiar with Jermell Charlo. Look, Jermell Charlo wants my title. I want his title, and I want to be able to unify the super welterweight division. What are your thoughts on other contenders at 154? Guys like Tony Harrison, guys like Erickson Lubin, guys like Terrell Gashay. ¿Qué piensas de otros peleadores ahí en 144 libras como Erickson Lubin, Terrell Gashay, Tony Harrison?
Oh, creo que realmente la división de las 154 libras está súper picante. Hay buenos peleadores, todos son competentes. Creo que realmente ahora mismo es una de las divisiones que está mejor en cuanto a competencia.
He goes, I think, 154 is one of the best divisions, in the sport. You look at the names that, I mentioned, Erickson Lubin, Terrell Gachet, Tony Harrison, they are all extremely competent and talented fighters. And I think that 154 is an extremely deep division. If you had your choice, Jason, who would you want to fight next? Si era la decisión de ti, ¿quién quieres en la próxima pelea?
Jermell Charlo, ese es mi objetivo, ese es lo que anhelo ahora mismo. Quiero ser el mejor de la división y quiero ganarle al número uno.
He said, my objective, if I had my choice, is Jermell Charlo. He is, the best in the division, and I want to go ahead and prove that I am truly the best at 154. Boxing in the Dominican Republic, Juan Guzman, you have Juan Carlos Payano. Did you look up to those guys? ¿Puedes descubrir cómo te sientes cuando viendo Juan Guzmán, Juan Carlos Payano, los boxeadores ahí en la República Dominicana contigo?
Bueno, realmente me siento bien, bien motivado al saber que he podido lograr logros y estar al lado de grandes campeones como lo es Joan Guzmán, Juan Carlos Payano, como lo es Marrero, un sinnúmero de campeones que realmente han logrado lo que tienen a base de trabajo y a base de sacrificio.
He said those champions like, Juan Carlos Payano and also, just looking at all the guys, Joan Guzman, Claudio Marrero, they've sacrificed a lot. It means a lot for me to be able to stand side by side with them, now being a current world champion. Going ahead and looking at what is to come in the future, Jason, what are your thoughts on fighting without fans? ¿Qué piensas peleando en una arena sin fanáticos del boxeo? ¿Qué piensas de eso?
Realmente yo no tengo ningún tipo de problema. Yo me siento preparado mentalmente. Creo que si tendría que defender mis títulos en una arena sin fanáticos, creo que lo haría de la misma manera como si hubieran millones de fanáticos. Yo no tengo problema y me gustaría hacerlo como sea, sin fanáticos. Con fanáticos, no importa, realmente lo que quiero son los títulos.
He goes, it doesn't matter to me if, fight fans are there or they're not there. My preparation, my concentration is going to be the same, with or without fans. So, nothing is going to change on my end. My only focus is to become the undisputed super welterweight champion of the world. And also, Jason, have you been in the gym? Have you been training? Have you been running? ¿Qué estás haciendo físicamente para estar en el mismo en tu mente? ¿Estás en el gimnasio ahorita? ¿Qué puedes descubrir cómo está pensando contigo?
Bueno, realmente ya estoy entrenando 2 veces al día. Entreno por la mañana con mi entrenador, luego entreno en la tarde en casa. Ya mañana estoy en Estados Unidos, ya estoy oficialmente prácticamente en mi campamento, esperando cualquier decisión que se tome para no ir sin condiciones. Quiero ir al 100 para ganarle a Charlotte. Tengo que prepararme al cero y creo que sí, sí va a ser algo bien bien motivador el trabajar pensando en Charlotte.
He goes, I am right now, I'm working out twice a day in the morning with my trainer. You know, I'm putting in the work in the afternoon. I'm heading to the United States tomorrow to fully begin my training camp. But right now, the only thing on my mind is Jermell Charlo, and that is a major motivating factor for me, knowing that that is potentially in front of me. Finally, Jason, and we greatly appreciate your time, and thank you so much for everything, but can you tell us about what you want to tell all the fight fans around the world during this time? ¿Tienes un mensaje para los fanáticos del boxeo y de tuyo que estamos en unos tiempos con el coronavirus?
Bueno, el mensaje que le podría dar es que no se desesperen, estén calmados. Creo que este virus, el coronavirus, es una enseñanza, es de aprendizaje para que aprendamos lo que es la unidad, lo que es el saber valorarnos. Creo que el mensaje que le quiero dar a las personas es que se cuiden y ámense, quiéranse. Y creo que realmente vamos a aprender y vamos a ganar esta batalla con el coronavirus.
We're going to learn a lot. Let's all be safe. Let's all protect ourselves. But, you know, at the end of the day, we are going to, you know, prevail and defeat the coronavirus as a society. Final question, Jason. Do you see yourself remaining here at 154, or do you have plans down the line to move up to 160? ¿Quieres estar aquí en 144 libros o vas a mover adelante ahí a 160 libras?
Realmente no tengo problemas para hacer las 154. Voy a coger todos los títulos. Voy a hacer mi campaña aquí en 154. Depende de lo que decida mi equipo, Samson, mis entrenadores, mi manager. Entonces se decide si nos vamos o nos quedamos en la 154, pero no tengo problema realmente en coger todos los títulos de la 154 e ir a la 160.
He said, right now I don't have any problems making 154. I mean, it's not hard for me to make the weight. My focus is to collect all the belts in the super welterweight division. And once I do that, and once I have them all in my possession, then I'm going to turn to my trainer, my promoter, my manager, and then we will decide whether or not it's advantageous for me to move up to 160 or stay here at 154. But as of this moment, I have no plans to move up to 160. My focus is 154 and collecting all the championships. Jason, muchas gracias. Thank you so much for your time. Stay safe. Y nos vemos en mucho tiempo.
Gracias, gracias, gracias. Pasen buenas.
Jermell, it is great to talk
Hello.
With you.
Hello, how y'all?
How are you doing, my friend?
How y'all doing today?
Okay, so
y'all got me all fucked up. I don't know what Rosario said.
Okay,
sorry to interrupt y'all show.
I'll tell you.
You got born anyway.
I'll tell you what he said.
Take a break.
Can I tell you what he said? He said that he has no problem fighting you. He said he has no problem fighting you. He said,
"Hey, we don't care. I mean, his manager said that they didn't want to fight me right away. If y'all know the facts,
I'm
glad they're ready to fight. I'm glad they're ready to fight. I'm in shape. You see me? Always in shape, tip top shape. Yeah, PBC, that's me.
So Jermell, he said that he has no problem fighting you. He said that he wants your title just as much as you want his title. What are your thoughts? You know, how do you respond to that?
Come on, man. Y'all know what we do this for a reason. I'm here to eat. And if he in a way, he getting trucked. And I'm cool with it. I'm cool with everything that they got to say. We don't want to put no fear in him. We want him to come and fight. And it's been a dream to always have all of the belts. And if it's that easy, thank you. I'm just going to tell the man above, thank you.
What? You know, Jermell, Jason said he's coming to the United States. He's been training twice a day, and that he's going to hear from his management team over the next few days.
He's going to end up overtraining.
Have you thought about Have they told you potentially when you might be back inside the ring?
Man, we're gonna fight this year. That's all I can say. And if we don't fight this year, we're gonna fight soon. We're gonna always be ready. My birthday coming up, we finna get ready to be 30. So I don't got time to be playing games. It's time to get all of the belt and become the cash cow, do what I gotta do and let the young ones have it.
How do you see a fight with Rosario playing out? What did you see in his fight with Julian Williams that you feel, not giving away too much of a game plan, but what are some things you feel you can expose from him?
Why my comments went off? You must have cut them comments off.
You want me to keep the comments on? I can keep them on if you want.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
I just like to talk with you. That way we don't go ahead and, you know, get distracted. But I'll turn them back on for you so we can go ahead.
Yeah, I love my fans. I have fans that I love.
Oh, I got you.
I love my fans. Okay. They not everybody hate us. It's okay. most of them love me now. That's what Floyd did. Floyd went on to turn all of them haters into lovers. I've seen a whole bunch of that happen.
But Jermell
got the title back and all of that. But to answer that question about Rosario, Julian Williams, they fight did that shit old now. We passed that. Life has changed for a lot of people, and I'm great at adapting to things. I'm ready. I can't believe I was. I'm like, yeah, I'm bored. Let me check on what they doing. And I hear you in here talking, and you don't know what you know what you're talking about. You got your own opinion. They were great. You ain't take no break yet. I don't know why you ain't take a break, but I'm gonna go on and help you out. And it's cool, man.
Well, Jermell, have you been, you know, you're obviously in very good shape, excellent shape, but, you know, what are you doing to kind of maintain your, you know, your fitness level and stuff? Are you in the boxing gym? I mean, you have a lovely house. It looks like down in Houston, but, you know, what are you doing to kind of keep yourself in shape and keep yourself sharp?
We got a sauna in the back, so it's bikes everywhere. I mean, you got to stay in shape to be in this game. You got to be in shape. It ain't going to work if you don't stay in shape. I own a boxing gym, 8,700 square feet. My boxing gym called Charlotte Boxing and Fitness Club. We've been shut down since the quarantine, but I make sure every boxer is in shape and stay. That's how we lines only run. I don't know what to tell you. See y'all in the comments. Mike Tyson shook something up the other day. I like how y'all boxing. I like it. See, they used to put all these other cornballs. Now they putting bananas. That's dope. Oh, let me get off some comments.
Oh, what do you want to tell all the fight fans around the world? You know, we hope to see you back inside the ring sooner rather than later. But, you know, during these uncertain times of the coronavirus.
Stay tuned. We're going to get back in the ring when we can. It's not easy. They got to get this stuff together first before they can decide to get it back together. And when they do, I know it's a lot of hungry fighters and a lot of people ready to box, and that's what boxing is right now. It's this new era of things, and they ain't got a lot of fighters like me, so we in this thing, lines only forever.